पार्ट टू, रोबोट काइनेमेटिक्स, फॉरवर्ड काइनेमेटिक्स यूजिंग रोबो एनालाइजर एंड मैटलैब। नाउ फर्स्ट वी विल डिस्कस अबाउट रोबो एनालाइजर, देन वैलिडेशन ऑफ स्काडा रोबोट यूजिंग रोबो एनालाइजर एंड मैटलैब। आफ्टर दैट वैलिडेशन ऑफ 5 एक्सिस आर्टिकुलेटेड रोबोट यूजिंग रोबो एनालाइजर एंड मैटलैब। नाउ व्हाट इज रोबो एनालाइजर? रोबो एनालाइजर इज अ 3D मॉडल बेस्ड सॉफ्टवेयर दैट कैन बी यूज्ड टू टीच एंड लर्न द रोबोटिक्स कॉन्सेप्ट्स। It is an evolving product developed in Mechatronics Lab, Department of Mechanical Engineering at IIT Delhi, New Delhi, India. Why we use RoboAnalyzer? It is difficult to understand the forward and inverse kinematics initially by students. This is due to the fact that forward and inverse kinematics involve 3D transformations. We know that the industrial robots are represented using Denevit and Hertenberg parameters, that is DH parameters, which are a bit difficult to perceive and visualize in 3D. RoboAnalyzer aims to ease out the difficulties for students as it gives the 3D visualization of the robot with animation. Features of RoboAnalyzer: it has serial manipulator with prismatic and revolute joints. We can take DH parameters as input. 3D model can be generated based on DH parameters. We can visualize DH parameters. We can perform forward kinematics, inverse kinematics, inverse dynamics, forward dynamics. It shows animation with trace of end effector. We can plot graphs. It has virtual robot module. We can save and open robot models. Now this is the software. First, in the file option, we have 3 options. That is, we can create new file, we can open old file, we can save the file. Then HTM module. HTM module stands for Homogeneous Transformation Matrix Module. Virtual robots. It is basically a pre-designed robot simulator. Now here we have browser, in which we can do zoom in and zoom out, select view, trace and effector. We can change the background colors. There are some simulation keys and we can do some analysis also. Now we can do forward kinematic analysis by this key. And by this key, we can do inverse kinematic analysis. Now here we have some options. Degree of freedom. We can select the robots. We can choose custom robots too. Now here we have DH parameters table. We can change the values by putting the values in it. Here we have various configuration, which can be updated after putting the DH parameters. Now let's see how can we put the values to the DH parameter table and can get transformation matrix. Now here we can change the degree of freedom by clicking on this, and we can select the type of robot. Like we select 2R, that is 2 revolute joints. And let's load the selected robot. Now we can put the values of DH parameter in this table. And after that, we can update the end effector configuration. So here is the transformation matrix, or we can say end effector configuration. We can see the link configuration also, like link 2 configuration with respect to previous frame. Let's update it. So we can see the link 2 transformation matrix with respect to previous link, that is link 1. We can also see the transformation matrix with respect to base frame by changing the option. Now let's update it. So in this way, we can put the values in the DH parameters table, and then we will get our transformation matrix. We can perform some analysis also, like forward kinematic analysis. And now we can play it also. So in this way, RoboAnalyzer software can be used. Now let's understand that how the code works. So let's open the main file. Now here we will define some global variables. Now here NJ stands for number of joints, NF stands for number of frame, DOF stands for degree of freedom, and theta is our joint angle. Now we will set the number of joint here, and here we will call the DH parameter text file, which is saved in the same path. Let's open it. Now here we can see the first line is number of joint, second one is degree of freedom, and here we have the DH parameter table. So we can change it according to our robot. Now let's close it. Now moving further, the memory allocation has been done. After that, we will call some functions. Now to calculate homogeneous transform of each frame, we will call this function arm matrix, which is also saved as a function file at the same path. Now let's open it. So now here we can see it's a function file to calculate the arm matrix. Now again, we will define some global variables. Now here we will check that input file is being found or not. Now moving further. Now here, the number of joint, degree of freedom, and number of frame will be scanned from the input file. Now here, we can see that if the number of joint is less than 1, then it will display that wrong input. Please check the number of joints. Now we will scan all the DH parameters like alpha, A, D, theta, actuator velocity, and the flag. Now here for rotational joint, the flag will be equal to 1, and for prismatic joint, the flag will be equal to 0. So now to calculate the arm matrix, if the flag is 0, that is the joint is prismatic type, so this matrix will be followed. Else, for the case of a revolute joint, or we can say rotational joint, this matrix will be followed. So now let's come back to the main code. So after calling the arm matrix, now let's set the tip frame value and base frame value. After that, let's evaluate the concatenated matrix. So let's see the concatenated matrix function file. Now if tip and base is same or equal to 0, then this term will be executed. Else if the tip value is greater than the base value, then this for loop will be followed and we will get our concatenated matrix. Now let's come back to the main code. So if we execute the whole code, so we can get our final concatenated matrix, or we can say our transformation matrix. So here we got the results. Now here we have SCARA robot. We can see the SCARA robot with its proximal variant DH parameter table and transformation matrix. Here we can see that the geometric validation of SCARA robot in both the variants. So end result will be the same. Now let's see the SCARA robot validation through the softwares. Here we have distal variant DH parameter table of SCARA robot. Now let's assume some values. When we put these values in the transformation matrix, then we will get this resultant matrix. Now let's do the validation through RoboAnalyzer. Here, first of all, we will select the degree of freedom, that is 4, and then select the robot to SCARA. Now load the robot. Now put the DH parameters. Now let's see the end effector configuration, that is transformation matrix. Let's update it. So here we can see the transformation matrix. Now let's do the validation through MATLAB. Now let's open the main code file and the text file also, in which we will put the DH parameters. Now number of joint is equal to 4, degree of freedom is equal to 4, and here we will write the values. So now put the number of joint is equal to 4. Now tip frame is equal to 4 and base frame is equal to 0. Now to plot the final matrix, let's run the code. So here we can see we got the results, and this is our transformation matrix. Now here we have 5 axis articulated robot. Here we can see the robot and its proximal variant DH parameter table. Now we can see the 5 axis geometric validation of pose 1 in both the variants. So the end result will be the same. That is, both the transformation matrix will be the same. Now let's see the validation for pose 1 of the robot through the softwares. Here we can see distal variant DH parameter table. Now let's assume some values. Now we will put the values in the transformation matrix. Then we will get this resultant matrix. Now let's do the validation through OpenAnalyzer. Now for this configuration, let us select a custom robot by clicking on new custom robot option. Now here we have to enter the DOF, that is degree of freedom. So we will put 5. Okay. Now we will fill the DH parameter table. Now click on the create robot. So now here we can see the robot. Now let's check end effector configuration, that is transformation matrix. Let's update it. So here we got the results. Now let's do the validation through MATLAB. Now let's open the code file. As we know, number of joint is 5, so we'll write 5 here. Now tip frame is equal to 5 and base frame is equal to 0. Now let's put all the DH parameters in this text file. So the number of joint is equal to 5 and degree of freedom is equal to 5. Here we have retain all the DH parameters. Now, let's run this code to plot the final metrics. So here we have the final metrics, which is also known as transformation metrics. Now let's come to the pose 2. Here we can see the 5-axis geometric validation of pose 2 in both the variants, so the end result will be the same. Now let's see the validation for pose 2 of the robot through the softwares. Here we have distal variant DH parameter table. Now let's assume the values. Now when we put the values in the transformation matrix, then we will get this resultant matrix. Now let's see the validation through RoboAnalyzer. So now first of all, you will select the degree of freedom to 5. Select the robot to 5R. Load the robot. Now we will put the DH parameters to the table. Now let's see the end effect configuration. Let's update it. So here we got the results. Now let's see the validation through MATLAB. Now let's open the code file. As we know, the number of joint is equal to 5. So we'll put 5 here. The tip frame will be 5 and base frame will be 0. Now, before plotting the final matrix, let us check the DH parameter also. So, the number of joint is equal to 5 and the degree of freedom is equal to 5. And here we have written all the DH parameters. So, let's close it. Now to get the final matrix, that is our transformation matrix, let's run this code. So here we have our final matrix or our transformation matrix. Thank you.